shall be in here. This is Contemporary Jazz Night at CMK Gallery. This event is sponsored through Groupmuse, which, is anyone here familiar with Groupmuse, or is this
Tell us about Groupmuse, Trevor.
Groupmuse is an awesome little organization, and it's actually not that little because it's all around the world, that basically creates opportunities for musicians to perform self-organized concerts. Groupmuse takes place a lot of the time in people's living rooms or backyards, or, you know, tonight we're in an art gallery. But anyone with the space can sign up to host through Groupmuse. And, you know, you can have local musicians play in your spot. That's basically how it works. If anyone is interested, we do highly recommend, if you're able to, RSVP to this event through Groupmuse so that they know that you're here. That's how that organization thrives and is able to flourish. There's a little QR code on that stool over there. We'll pass it around during our intermission, so you can scan the QR code, register for the event. Also, you can pay the musicians electronically by scanning that QR code. We are asking for a $15 minimum contribution from everyone. I totally understand that, you know, sometimes times are tough, you're not able to make a contribution. I get it, you know, we've all been there. That being said, I don't see Ornette Coleman here. We're not playing free jazz. So, you know, contribute what you're able to. If you're not able to afford 15, you can only afford 30, like, we'll still accept it. You know? If you can't afford 30, you can only afford 100, like, we'll play it. But, you know, we'll pass around the bucket during the intermission and, you know, do all that. I want to acknowledge our owner of this gallery who's doing some running around, taking care of some stuff, is Keith Oliver. He's the owner of this gallery. Keith is selling refreshments tonight, is that right?
Yeah, whatever you guys, water, whatever you guys
need. If you want water, if you want maybe beer or something, see Keith, he'll be around. And this gallery is a pretty cool spot. You know, we do a lot of different events here. There's you know, some small theater shows that go on here. There's some art classes, theater classes, music events go on, open mics. You know, there's a lot of stuff that happens here. So if you're curious about this, talk to Keith. If you like any of this artwork, you want to learn more about it, talk to Keith with your guides. So yeah, that's Groupmuse, that's CNK Gallery, and the musicians that you are watching tonight are really good friends of mine. I'm really glad to be playing with these people. We've got Evan Hamaguchi on the tenor saxophone and B-flat clarinet. We got Charles Colizza over on the guitar. And we've got Ben Freidkin on the drums. And my name is Trevor Robertson, and this is tune we're going to play tonight is a composition of mine. This is called Intersection, and this piece is written and dedicated to the Orisha Elegba, who is also known as Eshu, the owner of all the crossroads. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Powerful. And the story behind this piece, some of you may know it, many of you may not, but the story behind this piece is that I wrote it after someone that I love, someone very close to me, passed away. And the title, More Powerful Than You Can Possibly Imagine, comes from Star Wars. Obi-Wan Kenobi, right before he dies, he says, "If you strike me down, I shall become more powerful than you can possibly imagine." And as a child, watching that movie, that line never really made any sense to me. I was like, how can he be stronger if he's dead? That doesn't make sense. But now as an adult, and having lived some life and having seen some things, and I can tell you that I believe in my whole heart that the people we love, when they pass on, they can become more powerful than they were in life. They can become, you know, something different than we could ever have imagined them. So this piece is dedicated to my loved one, but also to all of our loved ones who are now more powerful than we can possibly imagine.
Thank you.
Someone very close to me who had this habit of never ending a conversation with the word goodbye, she would always say, later, when you're parting ways. And I always thought that that was, well, at first I thought it was like kind of like, all right, like cool guy 90s skater energy, you know. you know. But then I realized like, oh no, that's actually really sweet and optimistic that I'm never saying goodbye to the people that I love. I'm always saying later, so. I love that about her, and I've adopted that in my own vocabulary. You know, I tend to say later. So we're ending this first set with later. We'll see you in a few minutes when we come back to the next set.